ridiculous. It's been some time, we've only made 2 sandwiches. There has to be a faster way to do this.
Did somebody say assembly line?
No.
Well, I thought someone did.
Who are you?
I'm Henry Ford.
Oh, the guy from the car company, right?
Not only did I start that company, but I also revolutionized the process that is used to create a lot of the products that are around today. In 1908, I created the Model T. It was a car unlike any other, not just in the way it was driven, but how it was made. My first Model T was made in 1908. It was glorious. I created a motor for the great multitude. Back then, there wasn't much in the way of customizing. You could have your Model T in any color you want, as long as it was black. You should have seen them then. They were marvelous. And yet, something was missing. There weren't as many people driving the Model T as there should have been. There was only one reason for that. Price. The car was less expensive than any other car at the time, but they still weren't affordable to the average American.
Well, you had expenses to cover. Of course the cars were going to be pricey.
Exactly. I needed a new way of making the Model T. If I could find a way to produce the Model T at a lower cost to me, I could in turn lower the price for buyers. And find a way I did. One day, 3 workers came to me with the idea of what is now the assembly line. They thought it would be better for the company if we scrapped the system of workers moving down the line, and instead, we made the line move to the workers. For this idea, the Model T would be stationary, and workers would come to the model and work on it. After the talk with my workers, the assembly line was adopted.
React to that?
Well, I believe someone in your time would say, haters gonna hate, or something like that. Other car companies believe that only the rich should drive a car, but I believe the opposite. People called me a traitor to my class for making the Model T affordable to the average American. They saw it as a waste to use such a lucrative method of procedure to make automobiles affordable to everyone. What happened after that? Soon after, the car was affordable to almost everyone. The dough was rolling in as fast as the Model Ts were rolling out. Thanks to the assembly line, we were able to meet the demands of buyers, shooting sales into the sky. In December of 1915, the millionth Model T was sold. We were changing lives. People who had never been more than 5 miles away from home now had the ability to go wherever they wanted.
Where'd you go from there?
From there, Ford evolved into a powerhouse for American automobiles. Trucks, SUVs, vans, you name it. Even the police drove Ford motors. While the look of the cars may have changed, how they were made didn't.
Throw all your cards aside and shuffle us, and you leave me
cars are still mass-produced, and they still use the assembly line. Now don't think the assembly line was just for cars. Almost anything you can think of is made from an assembly line.
Well, that was really cool, but what does that have to do with us? We still have these sandwiches to make, and now that we listened to your story, we have less time. Or do you? Try to believe, though the going gets rough, but you gotta hang.